Foundry VTT is probably my favorite virtual tabletop for running Dungeons and Dragons online. The main reason for this are the mods that you can install to adapt it for your table and make it feel right for you and your group. So in today's video, I'm going to be listing out my top 10 favorite mods for Foundry that you should be using. Before we get too far into this though, I do want to say I will be only listing free mods. So you don't need to pay to buy them and none of the features are hidden behind a paywall. All right. With that out of the way, let's get into it. First on the list is Simple Calendar. This one, there's nothing super special about it, but it's very useful if you're running any campaign that you need to track days or the time of the day. With Simple Calendar specifically, you can switch between our calendar or different fantasy calendars that they have selected. Second up on our list is the Compendium Browser. This is just a quality of life mod that makes searching things a bit easier. You go to the different tab, whether that is monsters/NPCs, items, spells, and just type in what you want. There's also some different filtering options if you're trying to look for something, but you don't know exactly what it is you're looking for. Number three on our list is another quality of life mod, and it is Tidy UI Game Settings. Tidy UI really just cleans up your game settings and makes things less cluttered, and helps my sanity a lot when I'm trying to quickly go through and adjust settings. Number four is Tidy 5e Sheets. This one's also pretty similar. It just improves the look of the different character or monster sheets. They are a little bit easier to use, and it also adds a journal tab to the character sheets. So if players want to take notes in there, they can. Number five is a popular one that you've probably heard of if you played Foundry much, and that is Dice So Nice. This one's really good for those people that just like watching the dice roll. I myself also enjoy that. There's different settings you can adjust to make it work better for you. You can adjust how quickly the dice rolls, the way the dice looks, when it displays the results, whether it's as soon as you hit the button or after the dice finishes rolling. It's a good one to have. My players really like it. I also enjoy using that one as well. Number six is Dice Tray. My players complain at me nonstop if I don't add Dice Tray because many of them don't like actually typing in like /R1d20. It just makes things pretty easy because you can click which dice you want to roll and they appreciate that. And moving straight along to number seven, and this is one of my favorite mods on this list, and that is GM Screen. With GM Screen, it's extremely modular as far as what you want to display. I like using it for things that don't come up all the time, but I want to quickly access when it does. So that would be things like conditions or exhaustion levels. You can also list out links. One of them that I like to use is to a random treasure table from the Dungeon Master's Guide. It just helps keep things running smoothly because players don't like sitting there waiting for 20 minutes for the Dungeon Master to look stuff up. This just helps you to stay more efficient as the Game Master and help keep things moving along. Number eight, which is pings. Pings are just a good way to point out things that you're talking about, whether it be items or places on a map, whatever it is. Pings are extremely useful. You can also hold shift and click ping, and that will pull everyone's camera to where you just pinged. Number nine is pop out. And it's just really useful to be able to pop things out and pull it off the screen, but then quickly pull it back in as needed. And last but certainly not least is Better Rolls for 5e. This one helps combat move a lot quicker because it does the attack roll and the damage roll at the same time. You can shift click or control click to roll with advantage or disadvantage. You can also go in and mess with some of the settings and adjust what happens when you crit and different things like that. So that's another really good one that I highly recommend adding. Well, that's it. That is the end of my list of the top 10 mods that you should be playing with. If there are any that I left out, please let me know in the comments. Like if you got any value out of this video, and I will see you next time.